Hey, what's up? It's your girl Neek, and you're tuned in to Neek at Night. And tonight I'm going to be talking about R. Kelly in this new sit-down interview that he did with Oprah's BFF, Gayle King. They are trying to get Michael out of here, and now they got R. Kelly to sit down and do this very, very emotionally charged interview. And I mean, if I was his attorney, I probably would have advised against it, but hey, I kind of also understand where he kind of just really wants people to hear from him and, you know, hear from him even if it probably isn't a good idea, but that's neither here nor there. Anyways, so Gayle has these clips that they released because the interview is going to be tomorrow. And in the first clip, she asks him something along the lines about him liking underage girls.
They are still talking about you with underage girls. Do you still sit here and say you have never been with underage girls? Can you really say that?
I sit here and say this. I had two cases back then that I said in the beginning of the interview that I would not talk about because of my ongoing case now.
Okay, fair enough.
But okay, I will tell you this. People are going back to my past, okay? That's exactly what they're doing. They're going back to the past, and they're trying to add all of this stuff now to that, to make all of the stuff that's going on now feels real to people.
But the past is relevant with you with underage girls.
Absolutely no, it's not.
Why?
Because for one, I beat my case. When you beat something, you beat it.
You were acquitted.
We can't double jeopardy me like that. You can't. It's not fair. It's not fair to nobody. When you beat your case, you beat your case.
But then Gayle gets a little bit more specific and she's like, hey, I'm talking about the cases that are current. The girls who are saying that you know, had them in these black rooms, all of the new cases of the women who appeared on the Surviving R. Kelly docuseries that accused him of all of these things. And this is what he had to say in response to that.
But I'm not talking about the one case in which you were acquitted. I'm talking about the other cases where women have come forward and said, R. Kelly had sex with me when I was under the age of 18. R. Kelly was abusive to me emotionally and physically and verbally.
Okay.
R. Kelly took me in a black room where unspeakable things happened. This is what they're saying about you.
These aren't
old rumors.
Not true. Whether they're old rumors, new rumors,
why would they say this
rumors,
about you?
Not true.
Then Gayle goes in and she wants to get more specific and she's like, hey, have you ever held anybody against your will? And his response is pretty much like, I don't have to do that. Like, in so many words, I'm R. Kelly. They want to be here. Okay, no, for real. Let me play the clip.
Correct me if I'm wrong, that you have never held anybody against their will.
I don't need to. Why would I?
Well, I'm
how stupid would it
never
be
held
for
anybody.
R. Kelly? With all I've been through in my way, way past, to hold somebody, let alone 4, 5, 6, 50, you said. How stupid would I be to do that?
I didn't say
you
were holding.
That's stupid, guys.
I didn't.
Is this camera on me?
Yes, it's on.
That's stupid. Use your common sense. Don't forget the blogs. Forget how you feel about me. Hate me if you want to, love me if you want, but just use your common sense. How stupid would it be for me to, with my crazy past and what I've been through, oh, right now I just think I need to be a monster and hold girls against their will, chain them up in my basement, and don't let them eat and don't let them out unless they need some shoes down the street from their uncle.
Robert,
stop it. Y'all quit playing.
Then he breaks down and emotionally starts crying, saying that he's fighting for his life, in which he is fighting for his life with these allegations. And anybody in his position, guilty or not, if you have all of the allegations against you that he does, you would be feeling some type of way too. So here is him, you know, breaking down emotionally.
Stop it. Y'all quit playing. Quit playing.
Robert.
I didn't do this stuff. This is not me. I'm fighting for my life.
Okay, so in addition, Gail also released some still images from the interview. And from these still images, in one of them, he's crying. And then another one, it looks like he's jumping up. So, you know, they're really trying to get the public to be like, listen, this is something that you got to tune into, you know, and they're trying to obviously pick the most craziest looking stuff to post, but it is what it is. That's the media. That's what they do. He should have known what he was signing up for. It is crazy. Okay, so y'all know none other than Mr. Avenatti had to come through with his Twitter fingers and play at the public's emotions yet again and, you know, fiddle their little heartstrings when I feel like maybe he should be using this energy to try his case and make sure his case is solid, signed, sealed, and delivered, however you want to say it. But hey, I guess in this day and era, you have to try people in the courtroom and, you know, you have to try them in the court of the public where, you know, you get people to agree with everything you say. And of course, people take anything Avenatti says as facts, just like the whole he went to McDonald's to meet with underage girls type of thing. Like in my comments on one of my videos, there was somebody like, no, you know, he went to McDonald's and he was meeting with underage girls after he got out of jail. And I'm like, dude, y'all just really take everything that people say as facts. When we seen the camera footage cyber stalking him, seen him not talk to anyone at his table. But anyways, I'm going to read to you guys what Avenatti is saying. This is what he had to say in his tweets. So he advises people to watch the interview. He says, watch this, please. Importantly, R. Kelly does not deny sexually assaulting underage girls. In fact, his answer demonstrates his guilt. He fails to understand that it doesn't matter how long ago it happened, and he also has no clue as to how double jeopardy works. Then he also says, R. Kelly tears are out of fear and despair because he knows that after over two decades of sexually abusing underage girls, we blew this wide open and have him and his enablers dead to rights. Hashtag justice. And, you know, I'm not trying to say what he's saying is not true as far as them having this case now, but I just pay attention to how he plays on public opinion. He writes the tweets in a way that makes it appear to be factual. You know, like him saying, like, you know, this proves that he's guilty. Or, you know, like when he did the whole McDonald's thing, is like he said it in a way that it was factual that he was meeting underage girls when it was like, dude, we seen that he necessarily didn't do that. I think he's trying to convict him before he gets to court with the public emotions, but hey, that's just me. But that doesn't negate the fact that if he did abuse anybody on tape and that person is 14 years old, he does deserve to do time for that. And like I've always said, we'll see how it unfolds in court. I just kind of wish that he would use this energy to prepare his case and get it good to go so that what he's actually guilty of, it sticks. You know, like certain antics like this, to me, it just feels like maybe your case isn't as strong. You know, I just kind of want to see everything unfold. And not to say that R. Kelly ain't guilty, because when I have doubt in certain areas, y'all take that as me saying that R. Kelly's not guilty. I just have doubts in certain people's actions, and I just see their actions for what they are. Avenatti has been known in the past to have cases where he says he has videos and he says he has pictures and things, and they never make it to court, but he puts it out there to the public, you know, and by the time the court case comes, it's a different ball game. And again, he showed screenshots this time of a video, but those look like the same video that we've seen before. So I say that to say, I'm waiting to see how things play out in court. I'm waiting to see if this video that he has is a new video, a new girl, new video, new tape, and looking to see if what he says is on the tape matches what's actually on the tape and if this tape is admissible, and to see how things unfold. With everything and all the allegations against R. Kelly, I understand why he's feeling some type of way and may be a little bit scared, because you're past is something that the court uses against you in the future. You know what I'm saying? It just is what it is. If you go and you steal something today at a store, a year from now, if you are accused of stealing something, they're going to use that against you. Even if you didn't steal nothing a year from now, they're going to use what you did in the past against you. So I can see why he would be a little bit scared. And, you know, I'm still questioning why his legal team would advise him to do these types of interviews. I would have been like, listen, let people think what they think. Let them feel how they feel. You know, prove yourself in a court of law. You know, put your facts up. You know, whatever, whatever. But hey, it is what it is. He did this interview. And when this interview drops tomorrow, I'll do a reaction video to it to react to the entire thing in its entirety to see how it unfolds. What do you guys think about Avenatti and his Twitter fingers? What do you guys think about this interview? I don't know how... I kind of don't like that they picked Gail to do this interview. I would have rather like Robin Roberts or whatever her name is. Well, no, I don't even want her. The one who interviewed Jesse, no, not her either. I don't know. I don't know who I would have preferred them to have interview him, but I'm kind of not feeling that they got Gail, knowing that, you know, they have this whole Michael Jackson angle where they're trying to take Michael Jackson down, and then how now, you know, she's sitting down with R. Kelly. I don't know how I feel about that, but you guys let me know what you feel about it. Let's talk about it in the comment section, and I guess we'll all see how this full interview unfolds tomorrow when they drop the full thing. All right, guys, if you're not subscribed to my channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button right now, hit that like button right now, and comment. But remember to be respectful in the comment section. We can agree to disagree without being disrespectful. Okay? All right, guys, peace.